back for around seven after that, and I have some questions as well. My two questions, and before I get to my questions, if I can just do some little administration here. I need to do a check-in. We normally close our meetings at 10:30. Obviously, we'll complete this item. I'd like to ask.
No, we don't kick any new items up after
10:30. Just finish speaking, Pat. I'd appreciate it very much. I understand that. That's why I'm asking the approval of the council that we go until we finish. We don't have too much left. Oh, we do have two items from the calendar that, Kat, were your items that I think we should address tonight as they involve scheduling and something's of interest to people who spoke earlier. We also have two pulled items. One item, which I pulled, which had speakers at the beginning of the meeting, that I think while we have their comments fresh in our mind, it's important that we respond to that item as well. So I'm hoping that the council will agree to just carry on until we complete business tonight.
I would like to revisit that question after we finish the slide, because I don't know how long it's going to take, given the amount of speakers that we
have. I think it might be good to set that determination now so that we don't have people waiting in the audience and then disappoint them a half hour, 45 minutes from now and tell them we're not going to take up that item. So I think we should determine what items we're going to finish tonight or not.
I'd like to recommend then that we complete our two calendar items and complete item number four of the consent calendar. And I apologize for having to do this in the middle of this.
Excuse me then, when are we going to be discussing the two agenda items that I've requested that we place on the council? Are we going to be meeting next?
I mentioned that we would be including that. That's what I first said. That we would be talking about those agenda items.
So our plan is to take up all of the items that are on our agenda.
It was the only thing I was taking off, and only because I'm hearing from council of concern. I would prefer to just go forward because I don't think that the items are going to take that long that we're addressing. I just don't want to keep moving things forward, and I think right now we're kind of wasting time as well.
I'm not sure if the deal is 13.
No, I understand that. I understand that. Yeah. I don't think that's going to take too long, though.
Well, how many speakers do we have for this item?
For this item, we have, I believe, six speakers.
For which item? For this item?
For this item.
I could put my card in yet.
Okay, if you could put your card in, that'd be great. So it looks like we have seven speakers. Okay.
That takes us to the
next. And we've gone late before at other meetings. I just don't want to keep moving things forward, especially when the speakers have spoken to items. And I don't want them to have to come back and readdress those items for up to speak to us. So can I have?
Are there any items we're not taking? I mean, are there any items we are taking?
We could move if Mayor Pro Tem, Council Member Eklund wants to, she had removed an item from the consent calendar, which was notice of completion for the Margaret Todd Senior Center, gymnastics.
No, I pulled that item, I want to talk about it. So my question did not get answered before the meeting. So I would suggest that, if the public speakers are going to take up until 11 o'clock, and then we're going to still debate this issue, then we're going to be taking up some of those items close to midnight. And I think that we've learned from past experience that proceeding that late in the evening does not do well for people who have to work the next day and take a bus to San Francisco or whatever. So, I would suggest that we move some of the items to next week, since we have a scheduled city council meeting for the 31st as approved by the city council in February of 2016.
All right, so if you agree to remove your two items from the calendar, and we'll bring it forward to next week, and also your item number four. I do want to keep item number four, because as I said, we had a lot of speakers who spoke to that, and I really want it. I don't think it's going to take too long, and I'd really like to address that this evening before we adjourn.
So then I will move that we move the two agenda items along with the consent calendar item dealing with
the Margaret Todd
to January 31st for our city council meeting, along with hopefully a discussion about our strategic plan.
I believe we have a police chief swearing-in ceremony also scheduled for that evening.
And that's at 5:30, so we don't start meeting at 6:30, and I understand that they scheduled it there because they had hoped that the five of us would be there.
Trying to give us enough time. I don't want to be shuffling people out of a very important event for our community.
It should be enough time.
I'm asking the staff.
That's right.
I would think that we wouldn't have any problem accommodating that, and all of the back comes available. I just want to be clear tonight, specifically which items we're going to push back to the 31st. If you could just list them for me, that way I can make sure the first has those, so we can do a proper agenda
Two questions. Just one curious. Out of those items that we just listed, is there any time urgency on it, or could we move it to the 4th, which is, I think, the next plan meeting actually was going to be, even though it had been? That's question number one. And then question number two is, with regard to the tobacco ordinance, it actually, my impression from the speakers was there's actually a call for a delay and a sort of examination of this ordinance. And so I don't know that if we waited to discuss it, that would concern the people who spoke tonight. But
what would we do there? I was hoping to ask for something. I don't know. I can't ask for it right now. So I'm kind of, because it's out of order. So, like I said, I don't think it's going to take that long if we can just complete.
Well, I have questions from some of that are going to be initiated by the speakers on that retail tobacco, so I don't think it's going to be a quick item. And our agenda that we approved shows that we are having a meeting on January 31st. If Councilmember Lucan can pass that along to Councilmember Fryday, and I do have copies.
Sure, this is an agenda that we have discretion over at any time. I mean, it's a question about.
It's obviously council action. If you can keep going down, that'd be great. This is the agenda that we adopted in February of 2016.
Which was a year ago.
So we always do this every fifth in our municipal code.
I'd rather not get into a big discussion about this. We do have flexibility.
Okay, the motion is to move it to January 31st.
Second.
All right. We'll call
the
vote on that.
Can
we get
specific? What
items
we're moving?
Yes, please.
And my motion includes all items that we have not taken up yet: the two consent calendar motions, the two consent calendar items, and the two agenda setting, and possibly one of the couple of items that were on our to-do list.
Could we maybe stand by number? I'm sorry. Does that include
item 13?
Yeah.
Does that include item 13? There you
go. So Laura's on.
Councilmember Eckley, does your motion include item 13?
That it includes the two that were on consent and the two that were on agenda. Is Laura's law time sensitive, Councilmember Drew?
I don't know the date that the county is discussing it.
They already did. They already discussed it.
No, they haven't discussed it yet. They had opening comments about it, but it's not coming back to them until about March time.
Yes.
So would you mind if we postpone that also to January 31st? Okay, then that includes
so
that one as well.
We're moving items 2D and E from the initial agenda setting. We're pulling the items up the consent calendar, which is 4 and 6, and then item 13.
Correct? Oh, right. Number 4 and number 6. Yes.
And
then
I-13.
Right.
That'll be moved to the
31st
of January. That's the motion.
It is council available on the 31st.
It should be on people's calendar.
Yes.
Yeah.
Double check. Okay.
When is the next meeting after that
scheduled? Because we haven't ruled, one of my concerns.
Scheduled for February 7th.
Excuse me. Because we haven't ruled on council members' request to discuss the dates of our meetings, I'm concerned the longer we prolong that, the more confusion there's going to be for not just the council, but also for the public in terms of when we're meeting. So I'm wondering if there's any way that could be expedited or discussed. I'm just concerned that the way that we're putting these items on an agenda in the future, where are they being placed on the agenda? Are we going to be addressing the ones that are going forward first before anything else so that we can get through them? So that this doesn't just keep happening, because I'm a little concerned that we're being so restrictive of our 10:30 time that it's actually causing some confusion about our schedule. I feel like we've lost 15 minutes right now in discussion of what we're doing. Again, my apologies.
For instance, I'd much rather tackle this stuff tonight
so
than have to come back on the 31st. And I mean, the part of the confusion of this also, to your point, I think, Mayor, is we had set out at the beginning of the year a goal of saving staff time and resources and taxpayer dollars and confusion of two meetings a month. And if we push items to the 31st, and then we also have scheduled, according to this calendar that was approved a year ago, we have meetings on the 7th, the 14th, and the 28th.
Right. So, Councilmember Fryday, we have not had that discussion. Not all city council members were given the opportunity to provide input on that. And so what I'm calling for on my agenda item is for us to have a discussion about that. But according to our procedures, I have to place an item on the agenda for us to decide whether or not we could place it on a future agenda for discussion. Not all council members were involved in that decision, and to me that is not appropriate. In fact, it violates several aspects of our policy manual, that's why I placed it on tonight's agenda, which was the first time I could do it since after hearing of the decision.
Which is why I'd like to address it tonight.
Well, we can't address it tonight because it's not on our agenda.
It would be on the agenda. Why can't I would oppose the motion to move this to the 31st and say, let's just power through.
But I'd like to just call the question to make that vote right now, whether or not we want to move it forward or take them out tonight. There's already a motion and a second out there.
Comment. calling the question requires a two-thirds vote.
Okay.
So that's four. It's four. That's four.
Jeff, can you see my hand?
Does somebody want to comment about this?
Sorry?
Is somebody just want to vote on it right now?
I'm sort of getting lost here. We have two very young people who are very strong. And I myself don't feel inclined to continue this process for the sake of the two young, strong people to midnight. Now, I can do it if I have to, but it is obviously not optimal for me or for the public. Certainly not for the people with children, certainly not for the seniors, certainly not for the working people who are getting up early in the morning and commuting to San Francisco. So let's think about not just our two younger members, let's think about our whole council, and let's think about our city. And powering on through, well, you know, we could just have a quick vote. We could vote it all up or down, and it'd be over. But that would not be in the best interest of the city. It is important to deliberate and to deliberate logically and carefully for the welfare of the city.
So the motion, thank you for your comments. The motion before us right now is that we, I think you made the statement before, that we're moving the items
to C and D. Sorry, 2D and E, the consent calendar items F4 and 6, and item I-13 to the 31st for meeting here to start at 6:30.
Okay, so that is the motion on the table.
Seconded.
It was made by Councilmember Eplin and seconded by Councilmember Drew. Please call the roll.
Councilmember Duren?
Aye.
Councilmember Eflin?
Aye.
Councilmember Lucan?
Aye.
Mayor Pro Tem Fryday?
No.
Mayor Athas?
No. All right, so that's a, what is that? That's a 3-2.
3-2.
All right, so with that, I apologize again. We're going to go back on this item. Thank you all for your patience in going through that painful experience.